and Seaforth sensations Tom Jordan and Mitch Thompson join us now. It's great to have you here. Congrats on all the success so far. But I need to understand how two blokes from the northern beaches of Sydney have ended up in the United States as country music singers.
Yeah, I mean, mate, it's a wild story, but to take it back to the beginning, Tom and I have known each other since we were 3 years old. We went to kindergarten together in Seaforth here in Sydney. But we've both been playing music our whole lives, but we kind of just didn't really know what we wanted to do with it. It was just like, we wanted to do music, but where does it go? Like, how does it take us anywhere? We got introduced to country music through our uncle, Keith Urban, which is what we tell people in the US. He's our uncle. So any chance to, like, help it a little bit? Like, he's our uncle, so it's good. No, but that was our first introduction to country music, and uncle genuinely Keith. it was a light bulb moment for both of us. And we're like, where does this... We wanted to discover where this came from. Like, the music we were loving, who produced that, who, like, where are the studios? And that was leading back to Nashville, so...
So is the Keith Urban myth the only lie you're telling them over there? Like, do you also tell them that the northern beaches of Sydney is actually country?
Because they were like, we're from a small town in Sydney called Seaforth. We tell them honestly, I'm like, country music is not something that we were surrounded by growing up here. It's something that wasn't really accessible to us. We had to, like, search for it. Mm. And in doing that, we discovered it and we fell in love with it, and that's what brought us to Nashville, making trips. And
my God, the Americans must love that story.
It's all scripted. It's all we've all been doing.
I love the fact that you suggest that he's old enough to be your uncle.
we met him a while back at an award show, and Mitch told him that story. And he was like, that's fine as long as you don't tell him I'm your auntie.
He slapped me in the face. Yeah.
Well, tell us about this name, because obviously Seaforth, right? Well, why did you pick Seaforth? Was sort of Balgala Heights taken?
Between that and Wakehurst Parkway. That's now a little more metal, so...
No, I mean, I guess, like, going overseas, we wanted to keep a piece of home with us, because obviously we are Australian and we love Australia, love our home, and so it's kind of a cool story. I will say being called Seaforth has definitely confused people when we say Seaforth over there with this accent. We've been called Seafood. Seafoam, Seafroth.
Seaworld. We got some orcas with us on stage.
We finished a festival a couple of years back, and it was right when we first released music, so the crowd was, like, kind of just people that were there just because they wound up there or whatever. And there was, like, an announcer after we finished, and he was like, make some noise one more time for Seafoam. And we were like, dude, how do you get that wrong?
So you guys have been touring in the States recently, and I heard that you actually played at the legendary music venue, the Grand Ole Opry. How was that?
That was amazing.
Unreal.
When we met our debut at the Ryman, both our mums were there at the time as well, which was pretty special because they hadn't seen us play and anything that we were doing over there yet, and they came out and we brought them on stage to make our debut, and it was, like, one of the most special things we've ever done. Like, them crying on stage, us trying not to cry on stage and shaking, but it was really, really special. Oh, there it is.
Oh, yeah.
That's me crying. It was incredible, such a full circle moment for us, especially for our parents to see that we're not lying and we didn't just leave them for no reason. We were doing
known for lying,
apparently we're just liars. But no one knows when we're speaking anything serious in the US, though, because it's, like, so straight face and sarcastic. Yeah. They're like, I never know if you're, like, having a go at me. Maybe it's just the Aussie.
You've been touring the UK as well, and you recently dropped your latest EP, which is called What I Get for Loving You.
Yes.
By the looks of your TikTok, you're really massive there. Let's take a look.
I know a Seaforth fan when I see one. You two look like big Seaforth fans. What's your favourite song?
What fan?
From Seaforth. You know the band?
No.
No? Thank you, fellas. So the EP's finally out. What song are you wearing out the most, do you reckon?
Sorry?
The EP's finally out. What song are you wearing out the most? Are you playing it?
I don't understand what language you're talking about.
We're pretty big over there.
I don't know how you do that. Mitch is like, you should do a couple. I'm like, there's no way I could keep a straight face and walk up to someone and do that, eh?
It hurts a lot. It's good for the laugh afterwards.
We did watch the longer version of that. There's quite a lot of it.
It's a lot. It's pretty embarrassing, but it's also, it's funny. We hadn't even played there yet. So I'm like, we're going to find all our fans.
If you said Seafoam, they probably would have been like,
that's who it was. We have a New York edition and a Daytona Beach edition too. If you
Big series. Netflix is buying it. It's going to be
All right, so you may not be great at the self-promotion stuff, but I noticed that you are great at merchandise because on your website, we found an item called the breakup box. Now, I don't know how well you know this, but in particular, there are three darts included in that kit without a board. Why?
So, Tom. Angry at someone, you know? No, I'm just... No,
you deserve.
I think, well, with the artwork for breakups, there were darts on it, and so somehow darts just became like a thing around.
We were speculating this afternoon when we were having a meeting, and we thought, is this kind of classic country music? You got the darts, she got the board.
Like a breakup.
Why do you have to bring that up?
Tommy gets very emotional.
If you want to catch Seaforth's last two Aussie shows before they head to the US, visit our website for more details. Huge thanks to Tom and Mitch from Seaforth.